Hello everyone, this is me Nidin, back with a new video. So in this video, I am going to cover the four questions as you can see on the screen. I have framed these questions based on the queries I received from some of my viewers in the previous video. Let's see each question one by one. Before going to the answers, we will have a quick recap on the present macOS versions that receives regular security updates and upgrades. They are High Sierra version 10.13, Mojave version 10.14, and then recently released Catalina version 10.15. In my previous video, one of my viewers asked me about running macOS on an Intel dual core processor. The answer is yes, you can run macOS on an Intel dual core processor just like running macOS on an Intel Core 2 Duo processor. But nowadays, Intel Core 2 Duo processor and Intel dual core processor are not recommended for running macOS Mojave and Catalina. And I will explain what are the reasons behind it. First of all, you must understand that macOS require a 64-bit processor with instruction set SSE 4.1 and SSE 4.2. If the instruction set SSE 4.2 is needed for running macOS Mojave and Catalina. The second reason is related to the power management. Intel dual core processor and Core 2 Duo processor are known for power management issues. We may need some tweaks and workarounds to get it fully supported in macOS. And the third reason is related to its performance. Intel dual core processors and Core 2 Duo have only 2/3. And the performance on these two processors on new macOS versions will be very poor. And the fourth reason is it requires proper DSDT patching. And DSDT stands for Differentiated System Description Table. And it is responsible for all the power events that are happening in your PC, like shutdown, sleep, closing the lid, reboot, etc. So because of all these reasons, we don't recommend Intel Core 2 Duo and Intel Duo Core processor for running new versions of macOS. But still, if you want to run macOS versions on dual core processors, then you can choose Pentium G4560 or above because they are having 4 threads. And still you have to note that you have to take some tweaks and workarounds to fix the power management issues. In my previous video, one of my viewers asked me whether he can run macOS in his system. He shared his specification and I noticed that he was having a Nvidia GPU. So I framed this question, what will be the support for Nvidia graphics card on Mojave and Catalina. Apple actually dropped support for most of the Nvidia cards from Mojave onwards. That means you won't be able to get full acceleration and graphical support in macOS, Mojave and Catalina in most of the Nvidia cards. The recently released Nvidia web drivers support only up to macOS High Sierra. But if you are having a Nvidia graphics card that is based on Kepler architecture, then it is out of box supported in Mojave and Catalina. You can use Wikipedia to search which are the Kepler based Nvidia graphics card. I will provide a link to the list of Nvidia cards that are Kepler based. Also, you can choose an AMD graphics card that is Metal API supported, which is also out of box supported in macOS, Mojave and Catalina. Now comes the most interesting question. Why AMD processors not support to run a Hackintosh? Nowadays, AMD processors can run macOS. Earlier there was a time in which Intel processors were the only choice for building a Hackintosh. Main reason for that is Intel processors are used in real Mac products. As you can see in the iMac specification page, the processor used here is Intel Core i5. But now the whole situation has changed. After the release of new processors by AMD, many communities developed ways to support macOS on AMD processors. The supported AMD CPUs are AMD FX series, AMD A series, Ryzen, Threadripper and Athlon. Hackintosh based on Ryzen processors are called Ryzentosh. Now we are coming to the last session of our video. Who will provide the support for building a perfect Hackintosh? There are lots of online communities in the web that can provide the necessary support and guidance in building a perfect Hackintosh. Let's see some of the famous communities in the web. First one is TonyMacX86. Second community is Reddit Hackintosh community. Third one is Hackintosh. Fourth one is Insanely Mac. Fifth one is AMD OS X. If you are having a compatible AMD processor, then This community helps you in building a perfect Hackintosh. Next is Hackintosh. And the last one I want to introduce in this video is Olarila. These are the communities where you can take help from many people around the world, where they provide you all the support and guidance in building a perfect Hackintosh. You can visit any of these Hackintosh communities and follow their guides in building a bootable USB and the necessary BIOS settings that must be applied for running macOS. That's all for today's video. If you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe. Stay tuned for future videos. Till then, take care. Goodbye.